Today I am going to discuss about the anatomy and physiology for the GNM first years. So in this we are going to discuss about the unit 10, that is reproductive system. So in the last class we have seen about the external genital organs related to the female reproductive system. So the in the female reproductive system, next we are going to discuss about the internal genital organs. So internal means they can only inside of the uterus. So there is a female reproductive system includes the external reproductive genital organs and the internal genital organs. So there is a internal genital organs includes the vagina and the uterus, and there is a fallopian tubes and two ovaries. So internal genital organs includes the uterus and vagina and two fallopian tubes and two ovaries. So the internal genital organs, first one is the vagina. So the vagina is become fibromuscular tube and it connects the external and internal organs of the reproduction. So the vagina is become fibromuscular tube. So it is become tube structure and it can be connects to the external and internal organs of the reproduction. So the what are the organs can be included in the reproductive system, and the vagina is connected to the externally or internally to the reproductive organs. So there is a vagina, it is become connects to the external and internal organs of the reproduction. And the next one is the structure. So the structure of the vagina, it includes the three layers. So there is a outermost layer and the middle layer and innermost layer. So these three layers should be include in the vagina. So the structure, it includes the three layers, that is the outermost layer and the middle layer and the innermost layer. So the functions of this vagina is become, there is a, it can be act as a receptacle for the penis. So during the intercourse it can be receptacle for the penis. So and the next, there is a function, there is a it can be act as a elastic passageway during the childbirth. So the main function of this vagina, it can be act as a elastic passageway and during the childbirth. So during the childbirth lo idi oka elastic passage way lekka pani chestundi. So baby birth ayye samayamlo ee vagina anedi elastic ante vedalpuga avutundi. So the vagina, it is become act as a elastic passage way during the childbirth. So it is the functions of the vagina. So the next one is the blood supply to the vagina. So there is a uterine and vaginal arteries. So there is a blood supply to the vagina by the uterine and the vaginal arteries. So it is about the vagina. And the next one is the uterus. So the uterus, it is a become pear shaped. So it is become pear shaped. So there is a, and it can be lies in the pelvic cavity. So the uterus become lies situated into the pelvic cavity between the urinary bladder and the rectum. So the urinary bladder and the rectum, between these the uterus can be situated into the pelvic cavity. So the vagina, it can be situated behind the rectum and the anal canal and the in front of the urinary bladder. So there is a vagina can be situated in front of the urinary bladder and behind the anal canal and the rectum. So like that only uterus can be situated into the pelvic cavity between the urinary bladder and the urinary bladder and the rectum. So the uterus can be situated between the urinary bladder and the rectum and it into the pelvic cavity. So the uterus can be situated into the pelvic cavity. So it can be measures about the 3.5 centimeters long. So it is the 3.5 centimeters long. So it is become uterus and there is a cervix and it is become vagina and it is become fimbriae and there is a it is become fallopian tubes and it is become ovaries and it is uterus cervix vagina so it is about the uterus so it is measures about the 7.5 centimeters long and 5 centimeters wide and there is a walls are become 2.5 centimeters thick so there is a thickness of the walls and there is a 2.5 centimeters in thickness of the uterus so there is a 7.5 centimeters long and wide is 5 centimeters and 2.5 centimeters the walls become thick so it is weighs about the 30 to 40 grams so the weight of the uterus is become 30 to 40 grams and there is a the uterus consists of the three parts so there is a fundus it is become fundus of the uterus and it is body and the cervix so there is a fundus it is become dome shape so it is a dome shape it is called as fundus of the uterus and this is the cervix so and it is the body of the uterus so the uterus consists of the three parts there is a fundus and the body and the cervix so it is become fundus it is become bone shape dome shape and there is a body of the uterus and the cervix so it is the three parts can be included in the uterus so the cervix it is become 2.5 centimeters and it can be opens into the vagina so the measurement of the cervix is become 2.5 centimeters and it can be opens into the vagina so this is the vagina so there is a vagina and the cervix can be measures about the 2.5 centimeters and it can be opens into the vagina so it is about the uterus and next one is the fallopian tubes so the uterine it is also known as uterine tubes so there is a two tubes the there is a two fallopian tubes can be connected to the uterus so it is become measures about the 10 centimeters long so the length of the fallopian tubes is become 10 centimeters in long and there is a two fallopian tubes can be connected to the uterus so on both side and there is a two fallopian tubes can be connected to the uterus so it is the fallopian tubes so the next one is the fallopian tubes the main function of this fallopian tubes it can be helps in the transport of the gametes so the gametes means there is a sperms so after the intercourse and the sperms can be transported to the through the it is fallopian tubes so the fallopian tubes the main function is transportation of the sperms so after the intercourse the sperms can be transported to the fallopian tubes into the uterus so it is the fallopian tubes so the next one is the ovaries so this is the two ovaries so the two ovaries and it is become 2.5 to 3.5 centimeters long so it is become 2.5 to 3.5 centimeters long and there is a 2 centimeters wide and 1 centimeter is thickness of the ovaries so the for this fallopian tubes there is a finger like projection it is called as fimbriae so this finger like projection is called as fimbriae so by this finger like projection and the fimbriae it is called as fimbriae and by this fimbriae the ovum has released from the ovaries and it can be catched by the fimbriae so the fimbriae the finger like projection is called fimbriae and by this fimbriae the ovum released by the ovaries and the ovum can be transported by the fimbria into the fallopian tubes. So fallopian tubes ki finger like projections anevi untayi, danni fimbria ani anta. So ovaries nunchi ovum anedi vidudala avutundi, ovum anedi ee fimbria dwara catch cheyabadi ovum anedi fallopian tubes lopaliki transport avutundi. So it is the ovaries. So the ovaries become 2.5 to 3.5 centimeters long and 2 centimeters wide, and there is a 1 centimeter thick. So the main function of this ovaries, it is become the secretes the ovum, and it also helps for the secretion of the estrogen and the progesterone. So there is a, it can be helps for the secretion of the ovum and also help for the secretion of the estrogen and progesterone hormones. So the only one ovary can only release the one ovum. So one ovary anedi okate ovum ni release chestundi. Ovum ante egg. So ovaries anedi okate egg ni release chestundi. Idi estrogen and progesterone hormone kuda secrete chestundi. So it can be helps for the secretion of the estrogen and the progesterone. So it is support the internal genital organs. So internal genital organs includes the vagina and the uterus and fallopian tubes and the ovaries. So it completes the female reproductive system.